I can't get out of the house in one piece. Dang.
Treacherous little twin, and you know that we locked in, and I love you like my kin. It's whatever for you. I go up and down that road, I go anywhere you go. When you tell me life is good, I want better for you. Yeah. You my twin, you my twin, you my treacherous little twin, you my twin, you my treacherous little twin, you my twin.
Hey friends, today we are at Home Goods because I didn't tell y'all. So we just moved to Houston a couple months ago. We need a rug, we need picture frames, we need a dining table, we need everything to make the house feel like a house for real. So we're finna go on Home Goods, see if they got a rug, see if I can find some wall art, because lately I've been hating every wall art that I see. I think I'm gonna just print some off of Etsy. I think that's my best bet, and buy the frames later. But we're gonna see how this goes. We're gonna see if we see anything and go from there. But y'all, guys, I'm trying to figure out, do I want a stool in front of our bed? And our bed is like a creamish, whitish color and brown. But this is so cute and it's soft. Uzi gonna have to fight me. Now, I wouldn't be mad at Uzi sleeping on this as long as he's not like biting on it and digging his nails in it like he do the carpet. Then the next question is, do I want actual artwork or do I want random stuff like this? Because the colors in the house are gray, black, and cream. I'm a real neutral tone person, so I'm trying to figure out what do I want the artwork to be, because the walls looking real insane asylum-ish and they're white. Okay, white. I need some pop. Y'all see this pimple I pop? I'm a queen of not leaving stuff alone on my face. I like these that I'm looking at, but I don't know if that's just gonna look like stupid in the living room. Do you like these? No, I'm asking. He finna go pee for me. Or you feel like? But do you want?
Where do you want to put it though?
In between that wall where the two windows are. On the other side of the couch that we don't ever sit on.
Okay. Yeah.
Or would you want to do like actual? I mean, I don't know, because I feel like the dining room is where I'm gonna put pictures of like friends and family. But
yeah, we really could just do.
I just like the cut. Like this is the perfect color.
We could just color coordinate with the living room just to put some shit on the wall.
Yeah.
You know, type shit, yo.
Okay, type shit. But out of these three, would you do all three or would you only
all
do
four.
Two? But that, so we need to paint the rim of this black though.
This one's not black.
That is black.
That's like gray, bro. Look.
That's,
it's like a gray.
Well, we would still have to paint that though. We can't have three black frames and then one.
You with that
brown,
but that's the thing though. So, you're not gonna put that behind the TV,
so no.
Might be one over here, so mirror that wall, that wall where we don't sit.
I didn't want to do all the walls though, that would have been a little much.
We're right to be two pictures then, boom and boom.
Yeah, let me show you the other idea I have. No.
I got all those pelts.
No, I'm talking about in your room here, girl.
Oh, no, girl.
Well, we got to put wall art in there eventually. Puzzle together, but that means we on the time limit. I'm not good at puzzles though now. So let me mail when I'm just handing you the end pieces. That's all I want. I'll
call you if I see something else in here.
Love you. Love you too, Emma.
Bye.
Again, this though. No.
No, 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 no.
So now we're at Hobby Lobby, y'all. Hobby Lobby is so like country. Is that the word I'm looking for? Real like cliche little home sayings in here, but they have this really cute, you can't really see out here. It's like a little play accent wall, but it's only two. I need four. I definitely need four because our TV stand is pretty long. So I guess it's back to the drawing board again. But we did see some stuff in Home Goods. It's just the stuff that we like, it wouldn't fit in the car with the both of us in the car. He would have to go pick it up. Whatever. So, now we're gonna keep going through Home Goods, see what we find at this point.
What's the name of this store?
Hobby Lobby. Why you say that? I called it Home Goods. Oh, well, Hobby Lobby. Y'all know what I meant. Today we're doing my hair. If y'all could see what's underneath this hat, it's atrocious. It's terrible. It's no excuse. And I'm tired of the curly hair. I know it's hot in Houston. I know it's humid in Houston, but I'm over the curly buns. It's only so many places to put a bun. And my head is really big, and I know that. So in knowing it, I know certain buns or certain placements make my head look way bigger, makes me, it's just not a no, it's a no. So with that being said, I'm tired of my curly hair, so I'm probably gonna straighten it today. By like Sunday or Monday, it'll be a little oily, and I have this curl band thing that I use. I've had it since like 2016. Y'all, I use my real, like I curl it with my real hair, go to bed, the curls be so pretty. Oily ponytail for like the next 3 days, and then maybe I won't straighten it again. But once really, before I do my hair, somebody needs a bath. He don't even know he's about to get a bath. You want a bath? You want a bath? Huh, buddy? Oh, you so excited. You don't even know it's bath time. You don't even know it's bath time. Now the thing about having white walls, oh, it's so dark, you can't even see me in here. There we go. Think about having these white walls. He gonna mess them up every time. Like, in our last apartment, we had like brown walls. Not brown, they were gray. Tore them up. I don't know what that spot is on that wall, but I'm finna get it off. These walls is too white. Too white for him to be tearing up my walls. But I'm finna give him a bath while I look like this, cause I'm not gonna be no good after I do my own hair. So, all right, y'all. I will show y'all what's underneath this hat, but you can kind of catch my drift with the bun. Okay, the bun is too old. So today, don't come for me when I show y'all this. I heard all the allegations. I heard what y'all are accusing my sis of. But I'm not gonna not use this. Okay? And let me explain myself before y'all go too hard. When I used to get my hair done, so my girl back home that does my sewing, she's gonna trim your ends before every service. Shout out to J. Clo. Y'all, if you from Atlanta, you've kind of seen her work. when she used to trim my ends, she's like, I don't know what you're doing, but like my hair, I feel like my hair grew in split ends. Like, oh, look, I got a little length split ends. And she's not a happy cutter either. So the minute I was in Europe and I started using this, y'all, I swore I was gonna come back from Europe and get a sewing, because I got a sewing for my wedding. I mean, for this wedding. I know she was gonna be like, oh yeah, girl, them ends is horrible, blah, 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 blah. They were great, okay? When I say, she just said snip, snip, and my ends were gone. So before y'all come for me, the bond maintenance in Olaplex. I'm not mad at you. I don't hear the allegations. I don't hear them. They don't exist for me. So we're gonna wash our hair. I'm probably gonna blow dry it before y'all see me like that. And yeah. Okay, friends. She is washed, she is blow dried, she is ready to be transformed into a whole new person. I'm on the look for a hairstylist out here, y'all. And let me tell you, I thought I found one. And I'm geeked. Like, I just followed her on Instagram because her work was good. Heck, Houston, Texas hairstylist or whatever. I did that. Found her page, immediately followed her, like, oh yeah, her work look good, blah, blah, blah. One day I was like, let me go look at her prices, because, you know, I just wanted to see if I wanted a silk press. You know, what was gonna be my price? I get the whole new client, whatever. Y'all, why I go on her page and for a new client silk press, it was $300. And I don't even think it was like 300 even. I think it was like 300 and something something. Yeah. Is Jesus himself finna come down here and flat iron my hair? What kind of flat iron you got? Cause to my knowledge, what? $300? Girl, please, please. David for David, not going. I ain't never unfollowed somebody so fast after seeing it. $300 for a silk press. And my thing is like, okay, I get it. Time is money. And usually I'm not the type of person to be like, you need to charge this much. $300 for a silk press in Houston, where 9 times out of 10, like, my hair is going to swell up after I step outside in Houston for 2 minutes without a scarf on? When I say I've never unfollowed somebody so fast in my life, I'm not even playing with y'all. Baby, unfollow immediately. Immediately. And I showed y'all we're gonna be using Baby Bliss. Once again, TikTok be in my pockets. Cause y'all told me to buy this. I ain't mad though. It's a good flat iron. But stay out of my pockets. I'm tired of y'all. And then we are gonna do my kitchen with the handy dandy $30 beauty supply. Never failed me, never failed me. First half done. Got some help. Got some help. Yeah, I'm happy that my hair, this, my hair long. It might be a little long, girl, but let me tell y'all. I'm just happy my hair is like growing, because I'm queen of like, cut it off. Cut it off. I don't care, cut it off. It's like healthy with a side of length. Shout out. Yeah, we almost done. I'm done. Well, not done. She is silky. Silkyana. Silkyana. Yeah. I'm a curler, though. I'm gonna bump some ends. So it collapsed. But y'all, She is good. She's done. She's probably not gonna last. What you say, friend? Oh, I can't get out of the house in one piece. Dang. Yeah, I've been trying to leave the house for 15 minutes. Because every time I come out to the car, no, I come out the bathroom or the closet, realizing I done left something. I come out again, realizing I left something else. Go in the kitchen, fix my little cup of water. Get in the car, where's the cup of water? In the kitchen. Then I go back in there, and I'm like, just telling my boyfriend, like, all right, I'm finna go. He's like, you want me to come? Do you want to come? I don't mind going to the dealership by myself. Like, I don't mind because I'm not going for the mess. Sir, do what I said do. Don't give me the extra. This BMW app is going to tell me everything I need to do. I'm not doing everything else under the sun. Get my keys so I can go home. I don't mind going to the dealership by myself. But we have a million other errands to run. We really got a long day. So get up so I don't have to come back to the house to come pick you up. Because that's just doing too much. Just make my life easy. And now I'm sitting in the car waiting. Because if I sit in the house and I wait and I sit there for him to get dressed, I'm going to get frustrated. Because he moves slow. So as long as I'm not looking at him, I'm fine. I'm just going to sit in here. Watch some TikToks. We're back, friends. We're at all my errands today. Except for the grocery shopping. We always just somehow forget that. And then we end up looking at each other crazy around like 10, 11 o'clock. But whatever. Got my car serviced. Went to Sephora. So I got my usual stuff. But I got minis of everything because I don't know if y'all been to Sephora, but they had like the mini, I know y'all been to Sephora. They had the mini drunk elephant stuff and it worked so good. My skin was flourishing. But then I seen them prices of the full size stuff and I was like, okay, little elephant. Work with me, work with me. So I also, my dog is so rude. I also was using, I think it was like salicylic acid, but the lady at Sephora told me this works so much better with the products that I bought or that I use. So I'm a big fan of the Glow Recipe. I feel like everybody is. The toner and the dew drops. And like I said, I was using a drunk elephant moisturizer, but it was just like the little simple one. So I asked her like, what's a good one other than that one? She recommended Fenty. So personally, I have not used Fenty since it first came out when the hype, but I also had the whole entire line. And my skin was a little more problematic back then than what it is now. So we're gonna cross our fingers, hope for the best. And that's the crazy part with my skin is like, if you knew me in college, you knew that I had glass skin. Like, I had period acne, but that was like literally just whiteheads. Now, girl, I'm fighting for my damn life. I don't know what is happening. Is it age? They do say when you hit 25, it's another level of puberty. Is that what's happening? I don't like it. But I also think it was the water. I don't know, because some people in Starkville say their water broke their face out. But baby, I can go to Starkville right now. I put money on it. that I can go to Starkville for a day or two and come back and my skin would be glass. I could put money on it. I already know instructions. Push until it clicks. So, I don't know. Y'all can see it, like, right here. But, like, I have, this is a problem area. And then, like, this is a problem area. And so, a year ago, I got full extraction done on my face. Like, itty bitty dots. I'll try to, like, add a picture here. I'll add a picture of my college skin. And I'll add, like, a picture of my extraction done. So, y'all can see, like, it went from here to here. Real quick, big difference. Feelings was hurt. Self-esteem was, you know, yeah. But like, I got a full extraction done, and I swear I would never go through that again. My face looked so crazy. And that doctor lied to me. I don't remember his name. I think he actually left that dermatologist I went to in San Antonio. But he's like, yeah, your face isn't gonna scar, it'll be fine. I was in Poland looking like an oatmeal raisin cookie. Like, all of this right here, y'all, it was so crazy. I'll really try to add a picture and so y'all can see. I was so sad. I think it was like days where we were in Italy and we were like getting ready to go. And I was just looking in the mirror and just crying because skin is so important to me. It's so important. I was just telling my boyfriend, like, I think I want to go to esthetician school because skin is so important. And I'm queen of picking at my face. I'm queen of doing all that. And I really want to stop. I really, 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 really need to stop. But it's so addicting. But we're really going to, yeah, my dog, keep barking. We're really going to work on getting my skin back like 100%. You know, glass. Real glass, like. But like, it's never a bad time to get some fresh food. You making me get on the elevator. Huh? It's some stairs right there. Or you want to walk all the way down? Huh?
Walk all the way down.
As long as I don't have to get on the elevator. I don't know how long my hair can last. So I curled it. So it can last in this heat.
It can't work.
At all. It's horrible parking. We felt fine in this garage. That is so low to the ground. Why do you just don't want to take the stairs? That's so low to the ground. I mean, if you like it that much, then get it, but you're not gonna be driving it when you're not here. Update. We went to where we get brunch at. And of course, really, it might have been silly of us to go at 6 o'clock looking for some pancakes and stuff.
Well, I thought that was like the whole.
I thought it was too.
You know what I'm saying? That's the whole vibe of that place. I didn't know it was just that's just brunch.
So now we are at Zaxby's, and if you judge me, judge your mama. Don't come for me still eating Zaxby's. I like. These people out in this world still eating McDonald's. The least of our worries. She got her food. Oh, she said go inside. Cause she walked. Did she just get out the car? Today, that's so rude. Today, my boyfriend's gonna let me. Ready?
I don't know if I'm ready.
Come on. It's not like
Get a little low. Get low. So I could. Because right now I'm looking like this. I can't, you know. Stop!
Hold on. You rushing me too?
You be so jealous. Oh, I need to see you. That lot of hair, you said. You looking good?
You can't be doing that. You looking good?
Okay. And is it more off?
Yeah. Okay. that's your thumbnail. Alright, so you feel like you're going up a little high now, I'm saying? For sure. You get, yeah, I feel you.
Please pardon my dryer back there washing my clothes. Today was a good day though. Went grocery shopping.
Stay.
And usually, y'all, I hate grocery shopping. But I think because this morning I was in a bit of a tood. No. I genuinely enjoyed it. I put my little headphones in. And I was zooming. I was moving in and out through the grocery store. But the rest of the day has been basically trying to plan my birthday because I realized my birthday sneaks up on me every year. It's almost like I ain't had the same birthday for 20-something years. But planning my birthday planning my birthday today. And speak. Planning my birthday today, I started sending my best friend like outfits. Like I was like, or not outfits, dresses. Because I said I just want a really nice dinner this year. And I started sending her dresses and immediately kind of got discouraged, I guess you could say. Like she's like, okay, like this is cute. What's the theme? Da-da-da-da. And that's where you lose me. I don't know if I told y'all this. I hate planning. I'm not a planner. Do not ask me to plan nothing. Don't ask me. Because I think it's a thing of, for one, I hate when people ask me a million and one questions. I hate repeating myself. And it's the pressure. Like, it's all on me if this looks horrible. But it's all on me if it looks good. But I'm a... go to the bad before I go to the good. I just don't like planning. It's not my thing. All my friends know that. Do not expect me to plan nothing. I could plan us a dinner. Me and you, we can go to dinner. Me and you, I could show up to a birthday cake, you know, at your crib, happy birthday. I could surprise you, but don't ask me to gather 35 to 50 other people to help surprise you. That's called setting me up for failure. I am not the planner. I'm not. So today, first of all, I don't have many friends in Houston already. I have maybe like 5. But my thing is like I'll invite 5 of those people. And I'm not even saying friends. I have people that I hang out with, but like, or that I know, but we haven't hung out yet. So I don't know if they would want to come to my birthday dinner, you know? But I would invite 5 people and one person don't show up, I'm sad. My feelings are hurt. I think you don't love me. So, and I'm not really that friend. Like I'm honestly really probably too easygoing as a person, but that's neither here nor there. I just am really anxious about this. And then 26, you fall off of your parents' insurance. I don't know my daddy's insurance all my life. I don't even understand insurance talk. Like, I think my dad tried to explain to me insurance not too long ago, and I just looked at him. I don't want to pay for it. Turn 26 is so dramatic. We already talked about 25, you going through a whole other stage of puberty. Now I'm following my parents' insurance. Pick a struggle. I ain't picking neither one of these, but I had to pick one, but it's doing too much. It's aggressive. So I'm planning my birthday dinner. I need to figure out insurance. Is it health and auto insurance? Child, I don't know. But, and my boyfriend is gonna leave to go to Poland for work again. So a lot going on. Between August and September, I'm stressed.
Why?
Because I'm trying to plan a birthday dinner with 5 friends, and if one don't show, I'll probably be sad. I fall off my daddy's insurance this year. But,
you are not alone. I'm here with you.
Stressed because I'm the child, like, I used to stay in somebody's emergency room. I used to stay in somebody's urgent care. I cough weird, I'm going to emergency room. I don't feel good, I'm going to urgent care. My stomach hurt for longer than 3 hours, I'm going to urgent care. $25 deductible me. And now I gotta just figure it out. Well, not figure it out, but pay for it myself out of pocket. I don't want to pay the deductible after I done paid out $300. Uzi. Uz. You drink water like it's like you just never seen it. I gotta stop recording. Oh! Right! Because it's not like he spread it, the honey.
A twinkle, twinkle.
Swallowing a Popeye's biscuit whole is really crazy. But that TikTok was hilarious because, like, before she even jumped in, my eyes, like, did like this. Look. You have no business swallowing a whole Popeye's biscuit in one bite. That sound like that hurt, but a biscuit do sound good. What time you going out? You want a biscuit and some honey?
Whoa there. Let me tell you something. Close to Popeye's ain't close.
Yes, it is. It's by my coffee place.
Excuse you coming in? What time they close?
Oh, damn.
Damn.